to shine bright like a diamond. If you can't tell by my outfit today, we are doing a do-it-yourself project. We bought our first home earlier this year and we hit the ground running. I'm the type of person, if I can do it myself or if I can learn how to do it myself and save the money, then that's what I'll do. Being that it was our first home, probably won't be our forever home, that was another reason why we decided to update ourselves. One of the many projects we started was our kitchen. We wanted to be able to update our kitchen in a budget-friendly way, and we have started to make the updates. As you can see from behind me, we've gone ahead and painted the cabinets. Got some of the appliances. The last to go is this awful microwave. And today we will be doing the backsplash. If you're interested in seeing how everything turned out, stay tuned and let's get started.
We went with a simple install method to help keep the cost down and to shorten the length of time it took to complete this project. Right here, you see me applying a simple matte double-sided adhesive to my walls and then removing the backing before I am able to place the tiles. So this is the point where I forgot to add my spacers, so we went with the minimal grout tile design.
It is officially 2 weeks since I started updating my kitchen and we're not done. Life happened. We had to take a pause in the kitchen, but we got majority of it done. Honestly, I felt like we got overwhelmed with trying to do the outlet cuts that we just took a break. But right now I'm on my way to Home Depot to rent the tile saw in order for us to do these serious cuts. Honestly, each project I'm learning more and more how, I guess, passionate I am about doing things myself. It's a great experience because I love the fact that we are learning new skills. However, the time frame that it's taking us to get these projects done is one of the cons of doing things yourself. But I'm gonna grab this saw and then hopefully we have a finished kitchen today.
Okay, I'm back from Home Depot. I got this mini saw cutter. We're not even gonna talk about how my reservation was canceled because I didn't get there in time. So luckily they still had some there for me to rent. So yeah, we're just gonna get these outlet cuts done and hopefully complete the kitchen today.
This method of tile work is great for beginners. We found ourselves being able to go back in and peel the tiles off where we made mistakes, and it gave a lot of room for trial and error. And by no means are we professionals. Again, here I am applying that peel and stick adhesive, and then I'm gonna go in and place my tiles where I want them to be. Lastly, we applied some pre-mixed grout to the walls, and then the project was completed. We used two boxes of 3x6 subway tile along with some pre-mixed grout, and this peel and stick backing from Simple Mat. All supplies cost us less than $300, and the project was fairly easy to complete.
We are officially done with the tile work. I really thought that this kitchen was gonna take me out. It truly tried my patience. We have completed the tile. The last thing to do is to do a fresh coat of paint, and our kitchen is complete. I'm going to show you a before and an after at the end of this video. But I hope that all the tips and sharing my experience will help you. And if you're interested in taking on a backsplash tile project, I say go for it. Go for it, do it. I surprised myself, and honestly, I feel very, very accomplished. So, hope you enjoyed this video. Any questions you may have about this project in the comments below, and I'll be sure to respond. Until next time.